Hello and welcome back to Mouse Dropper Gaming. This is Fallout 4 and we're going to jump back into the wasteland where we left off last time. Alright, let's see what missions we've got now. Let's do this one. Go clear out some bad guys. Sorry, I already see them there. Let's see what snipers I've actually got. God, it's really powerful. I do just love this game.
Got it.
Yeah.
try that again. All my weapons a bit, I think. I need to go unlock that door.
That's it.
There we go, the door's opening. See if we can draw them out.
Sound the all clear.
lock's really strong.
Right, let's go report back to him.
Better have some good news.
This guy's around, douche.
Affirmative.
Excuse me.
That location better be cleared out.
Affirmative.
Impressive. Keep proving your worth. I may start to trust you. Here, your payment. Plenty more locations up once you've prepped for your...
I'm ready.
All right. Here's details on the purge location. Complete the mission, report back to me.
Hesitating to pull the trigger on any of the Commonwealth scum.
monsters? Or monster fish? Maybe? I don't know.
I hear something!
Right, let's explore now. Be careful now. He's got my buddy.
You only kill the weakest of us. It only makes us stronger.
Can hang back. Doing pretty well. I'm having a good look around.
Let's play!
just heading up.
Hey.
What do you want?
Is something amiss? How do you feel about our relationship? You're one helter, and I'm proud to call you my friend. That was it?
Affirmative.
Someone there? Huh? What's that?
Still quick save.
It's on me again. That sound! What is it? I hear something.
Exterminate the heathens!
Something there. Must have been nothing.
Working well. We can do this.
I hear something. That sound. What is it?
Exterminate.
I love that. Did he get it?
Strong
it means it is the secret to human power. Sotan wants us to help him find it.
I shall lift our spirits, spice. Quoting from the bard. Good night. Good night. Parting is such.
Gonna splatter your brain! gone!
Paladin dance.
You need to talk.
Hey! You just attacked! No!
Sneak around this way carefully.
Our ears play tricks on me again.
Rex.
Many thanks for that timely rescue.
What were you doing up there?
I was attempting to...
What? Who's there?
Rex.
Many thanks.
I think I've earned a reward.
Ah, yes, the mercenary. A classic character. Underappreciated in most productions. Yes, well, in any event, I'm quite grateful. I'd like you to have this. Now, if you'll excuse me, I think it's time I left this awful place and returning to WRVR and resuming my career in radio.
Nice, okay. I see what he gave us. So I've quite a bit. Speak this bit.
Strong, hold up.
Go find milk of human kindness with Strong.
We need to swap some gear.
Strong use hammer, hunting rifle, and lasers. Not use other guns or armor. Those for puny humans.
Strong.
Strong go with human.
Why do you want to find this milk of human kindness?
Milk is secret to humans. Macbeth say milk make humans strong. Stronger than super mutants. Strong find milk, drink milk, make super mutants stronger than humans.
Not yet, but soon.
Hurry. Strong no like waiting.
See what's in here.
Hey, hold up there. First time in Good Neighbor? You can't go walking around without insurance.
Insurance?
That's right. Insurance. Personal protection, like. You hand over everything you got in their pockets, or accidents start happening to you. Big, bloody accidents.
Whoa, whoa, time out. Someone steps through the gate the first time, they're a guest. You lay off that extortion crap.
What do you care? He ain't one of us.
No love for your mayor, Finn? I said let him go.
You soft head, cop. You keep letting outsiders walk all over us. One day, there'll be a new mayor.
Come on, man. This is me we're talking about. Let me tell you something. Why'd you have to go and say that, huh? Breaking my heart over here. You all right, brother?
fine. Thanks for taking care of him.
Good. Now don't let this incident taint your view of our little community. Good neighbors of the people, for the people. You feel me? Everyone's welcome.
Good neighbor? That what you call this place?
That's right. We cobbled this little neighborhood together out of the freaks and misfits that just wouldn't be accepted anywhere else. You'll see. You make enough friends here, you'll call this place home soon enough. So long as you remember who's in charge.
A new player in Good Neighbor. Hello.
Well, hello. Everything here is guaranteed to injure, maim, or kill at your discretion. Except me. I only kill when I want to.
Let's see what you got.
Each weapon tested on someone who deserved it.
Something? Brotherhood of Steel better stay out of Good Neighbor. That's what I'm saying.
Oh, new face walks into my store. And you're not even screaming yet.
I've got a few minutes to browse.
All the supplies, money, or violence can buy.
Saved that Rex Goodman from the super villains, right?
Guess not everyone appreciates the bar, am I right?
It's heading this way.
Out of the den, Irma, but I'd never walk out on you.
Nick,
let's go talk to Amari.
Downstairs, you big flirt. Here for Amari? She's downstairs.
You got the memory pod loaded up? Oh, you're not Irma.
Dr. Amari?
Yes. I take it this isn't a social call.
This one's all yours, Nick.
We need a memory dig, Amari, but it's not going to be easy. The perp, Kellogg, is already cold on the floor.
Are you two mad? Putting aside the fact that you're asking me to defile a corpse, you don't realize that the memory simulators require intact, living brains to function.
Please. Nick told me you're the only one who can make this work.
This dead brain had inside knowledge of the Institute, Amari. The biggest scientific secret of the Commonwealth. You need this, and so do we.
Fine. I'll take a look. But no guarantees. Do you have it with you?
How much of the brain do you need exactly?
That is not an encouraging question. I suppose I'll have to make do with whatever you can find.
Here's what I could find.
What's this? This isn't a brain. This is... Wait, that's the hippocampus. And this thing attached to it? A neural interface?
Those circuits look awfully familiar.
I'm not surprised. From what I've seen, all Institute technology has a similar architecture.
So the brain is still good, right?
Possibly. There's no sign of decay, so the tech is probably preserving the tissue, injecting some kind of compound to keep it stable. But there's no way to access the memories inside without a compatible port.
You're talking about me, right? I'm an old synth. If the Institute built me out of similar parts, we might have an in.
There could be long-term side effects. I don't know where to even begin with listing the risks.
Don't bother. I don't need to hear them. Plug me in, Doc.
I appreciate this, Nick.
You can thank me when we've found your son. All right, let's do this.
Whenever you're ready, Mr. Valentine, just sit down.
If I start cackling like an old grizzled mercenary, pull me out, okay?
Let's see here. I need you to keep talking to me, Mr. Valentine. Any slight change in your cognitive functions could be dire. Are you feeling any different?
There's a lot of flashes. Static. I can't make sense of any of it, Doc.
That's what I was afraid of. The mnemonic impressions are encoded. It appears the Institute has one last failsafe. There's a lock on the memories in the implant.
Tell me you have a way past this, Doc.
Let me think. The encryption is too strong for a single mind. But what if we use two? We load both you and Mr. Valentine into the memory loungers. Run your cognitive functions in parallel. He'll act as a host, while your consciousness drives through whatever memories we can find.
All right. Let's get started.
Just sit down over there, and keep your fingers crossed.
See you on the other side.
Initiating brainwave migration between the transplant and the host. Mnemonic activity coming from the transplant. It's degenerated, but it's there. We're going to load you into the strongest memories we can find. They might not be stable. Just hold on. Can you hear me? Ah, good. The simulation appears to be working, although the memories are quite fragmentary. I'll try to step you through the intact memories and hope we find one that gives us some clue to the Institute's location. There. This is the earliest intact memory I can find.
Such a dummy back then. What did I know about how the world worked? Mom knew how it was. Dad was either drunk or not around. I guess he must have run with one of the raider gangs, but
remember,
I never really knew what he did.
You are experiencing these memories as Kellogg.
Don't know why Mom was
this
with him.
This may prove disorienting.
Maybe at some point in his life he wasn't a complete asshole.
This doesn't seem to be what we're looking for. There appears to be another intact memory close to you in temporal sequence. There! Try
the thing about happiness is you only know you had it. I was the worst thing that ever happened to her. If she'd never met me, she'd have stayed in the hub, maybe hooked up with someone who didn't kill people for a living. Probably been happier than she was with me. Almost certainly lived longer.
I'll connect you to the next intact memory.
How did you think this was gonna end, Kellogg? You thought you could just fuck with us, and we wouldn't fuck with
I
you?
I found another memory to try. I'll connect you.
This is really weird.
Mind if we...
There's always someone. I wanted someone else, dead. I didn't care where I was going. Ended up mostly wandering east. Getting as far away from San Francisco as I could, maybe.
Well, we seem to be getting closer. Try this next one.
Mr. Kellogg, I'm glad you decided to meet with me.
I finally ended up in the Commonwealth. I kinda ran out of road. The first synths weren't all that impressive. I'm good, but I'm not that good. You heard all sorts of rumors about the Institute. But I figured they were just a convenient boogeyman for anything bad that ever happened.
One of these has got to tell us something.
They were real, all right. They didn't know anything about operating on the surface.
Ah, there's one that looks mostly intact. Connecting now.
Override initiated. Cryogenic stasis suspended.
How's now the Institute's main operator in the Commonwealth? If they needed something done, they came to me. It wasn't usual for anybody from the Institute to come along on a mission, so this one stood out. I didn't know then who it was we were grabbing from the vault. Of course, neither did they. Not really.
Vault computers are still working.
Even then, I knew it was a mistake leaving him alive.
That's good. Checking through the...
I'm glad I didn't have to kill the kid. I'm not saying I haven't done it, but, How's now the Institute's main operator in the Commonwealth?
I found another intact memory.
If they needed something done,
whenever you're ready,
they came to me. It wasn't usual for anybody from the Institute to come.
Is that your son?
It wasn't my idea to settle down with a kid in the middle of Diamond City.
Good news, I think.
I thought it was a terrible idea, actually. But it was one of the old man's pet projects, so... Here we were, me and the kid, like a happy little family. I ended up kind of liking it. A reminder of what my life might have been if things had... This whole setup in Diamond City was part of some elaborate plan of the old man's. Seems obvious now that we were bait for our friend from the vault. Timing couldn't have been an accident. It's not how the old man works. I wonder if he outsmarted me in the end. Another loose end tied up. This whole setup in Diamond City was part of some elaborate plan of the old man's. Seems obvious now that we were bait for our friend from the vault. Timing couldn't have been an accident. It wasn't my idea to settle down with the kid in the middle of Diamond City. I thought it was a terrible idea, actually. But it was one of the old man's pet projects, so here we were. Me and the kid, like a happy little family. I ended up kind of liking it. A reminder of what my life might have been if things had... turned out differently. But there's no going back. I knew it was just temporary. It'd be back to normal business before too long.
Kellogg.
It's okay. One of these days you're gonna get your head blown off just barging in here like that.
Minimizing my exposure to civilians is a priority.
Forget it.
The new breed of synths could easily pass as human. Some of them did. But the Coursers, they weren't built to blend in. They were killing machines, pure and simple. Smarter. Stronger and faster than almost any real human. I'm just glad they were always on my side.
So what's the big crisis this time?
New orders for you. One of our scientists has left the Institute.
Left? As in?
He's gone rogue. Name's Dr. Brian Virgil. We know he's hiding somewhere in the glowing sea. Here's his file.
Wow. Some heads are gonna roll for this. Capture and return, or just elimination?
Elimination. He was working on a highly classified program.
No kidding. One of the top bioscience boys? Damn. So, I guess you're taking the kid back with you.
Affirmative. Your only mission is to locate and eliminate Virgil.
You're taking me home to my father?
Yes. Stand next to me and hold still.
Okay.
It's all over, but the dreaming...
X-688. Ready to relay with Sean.
Bye, Mr. Kellogg. I hope I see you again soon.
Bye.
Teleportation. Now it all makes sense. Nobody's found the entrance to the Institute because there is no entrance. Let me pull you out of there as soon as you're ready.
Side effects the procedure might have had. No one's ever done this before. How do you feel?
Next time I have to watch someone's life story, I want popcorn.
Well, if you're cognizant enough to joke, I think we can safely say that you're out of critical condition. Are you ready to talk about what happened in there?
We got what we needed. The Institute uses teleportation to get in and out.
Yes. Their greatest secret has finally been revealed. But that only leads to more questions. How does it work? Where do we go next?
That scientist Kellogg was supposed to track down. Virgil, we need to find him.
You're right. A rogue Institute scientist could answer all kinds of questions. Where did the memory say he was? The glowing sea? That doesn't make sense. No one goes there. Not even if they were desperate.
If we need to find Virgil, then I'm going after him.
If you're going to go, be prepared. You'll need some way to combat the radiation there. It's called the Glowing Sea for a reason.
How do I fight that much radiation, Doctor?
There are chemical compounds. Radex, Radaway. You'd need as much as you could carry. Maybe more. A sealed environment suit would be great, if you could find one. Or maybe one of those suits of power armor? That would be perfect.
I'll find a way to get through the rats. Don't worry.
Good luck. And be safe. By the way, I unplugged Mr. Valentine first. Removed the implant while you were waking up. He's waiting for you upstairs.
Okay guys, I will see you next time. Thanks for watching.